Hello, this is Samsa again from GamingOnLinux.com, and today I'm playing Ghost Control Inc. Some of you might think to yourself that, hey, I have seen this game before, and that's because we are actually revisiting this game instead of playing it as a new game. And that's because the game was released on Steam a bit ago, and the developers asked us to revisit the game because they had fixed stuff. And to be honest, the previous time I played this game, it was pretty horrible because you couldn't save games, and that basically meant that you couldn't really progress in the game, and that kind of made it a bit annoying. Luckily, this time the game works a lot better. The saving takes a bit, but it works, and that means that I can actually show you some gameplay a bit further on in the game instead of playing basically from the beginning. So I'll quickly pause the time so that I can show you around a bit. So welcome to my new HQ. This is basically the second HQ that you will buy in the normal London quest line. So I have a lot of stuff that I can do here. I have a lab where I can research stuff, though I need a scientist, or rather a hunter apparently. And I also have I can build training rooms and stuff like that. Let's create a training room here. It's going to cost a bit, and our finances are not doing so well, but I think I can manage. So let's build a training room here, and this means that okay, so we need a hunter in this room as well. Well, we don't actually have any of those. I only have two employees here. I can actually... This is the desk. Oh, actually, I can't show that stuff there. I can show it here. So I have Gregor Onk, and I have Percy Palmer. And these are my two Ghostbuster dudes. But yeah, now that I can save here, this game is actually a lot better to play. I'm not sure if any of you who have played this game had the saving problems that I did, but I guess some of you might have had those problems because I'm running a basic Ubuntu rig, so it should have worked, but it didn't. Luckily this time it does, so I can show you. The game kind of locks up. The music does play, however, but yeah, now it's saved, and now I can load that game if I want to. But yeah, let's not spend any more time here. I'll just quickly sell all the ectoplasm that I have collected, and let's actually go drive around the city, and let's see if we can actually find some missions for us to do. So my finances are not doing so well, but I am fairly sure that we can get a mission rather soon. Actually, I should probably head to the hospital because my guys are a bit screwed up. I've had a couple of those really difficult missions that basically almost screwed me over. So, okay, so now we are running low on funds, but we can probably... Oh yeah, so now we have a mission. So, I don't understand the announcement in the tube speaker. Oh well, let's check this out. Maybe it's ghosts. It's probably ghosts. So, tube station. Fine. Okay, let's head there and let's see if let's see what this mission is all about. So yeah, now that I have actually played this game a bit further, I have an extra Ghostbuster or Ghost Control employee, and I have also bought some equipment for my dudes. I have the basic traps that you get get in the beginning, but I also have this Reliabilitator, I think. So it's from open source devices, so yeah, obviously I had to get that. And it's a bit more, well, actually this is more precise, but actually, this sucks. To be honest, this kind of sucks. it even weighs more. It's less precise, but oh well, it's from open source devices, so I had to get it. But yeah, so...
The ghost eraser is in the building.
The ghost erasers, there are two of them. But yeah, so the gameplay basically works like it did in the previous video that I showed you. So it's XCOM-esque. So you basically move and you attack these ghosts. So we have a Halloween spirit here. This is the tougher one of these two. And then we have a poltergeist. And we can't really hit these guys from here. So I think we should head a bit closer and then deploy our traps and try to avoid any collateral damage that might happen. So it's still unlikely that we would hit the ghost. I'm not sure where the ghost is going to head from here, so I am not completely sure where I should put my traps. Maybe this is a good choke point. So actually I don't have enough action points to do that. Maybe we should just hit the Halloween spirit and see if we can actually hit it. Excellent, so we hit the ghost and now we can head a bit closer and maybe deploy some traps. And if we can't do that, then we can always just... And this guy can't, for some reason, place his trap. The trap might be broken or something. Maybe I should get a new one. I don't really know. At least we have one trap, so let's go here. Actually, let's go here. We don't want to block this path here. And I don't have enough action points. Well, my tactics are not exactly good in this situation. Let's head back and see where these ghosts actually go to. Okay, so we have some collateral damage. Not good, not good. Hopefully it's just these two guys, because the trap that this guy was carrying isn't there anymore. Okay, so let's plop that trap down. And now I'm out of action points, but I think I can still move here.
Let me hit you with my rhythm stick.
Really, you were that close and you still missed. I'm not happy. Okay. At least the ghost is still focusing on Gregor here, so that means that we can probably trap it. Okay, so the Halloween spirit is down to 2 energy, so one more hit and he's down. Okay, so we actually have a ton of ghosts here. Okay, so I think we might have to actually bail out. But I'm going to take one of them with me. Or two, if at all possible. So this is a ghoul, and it's screaming. And it has a lot of energy, so I'm not completely sure that we can actually take him out. But I'll try. So, no action points. How about you? Can you... Okay, so it's likely that you can hit. Excellent.
I will beam you back to where you came from.
Okay, so let's see if that guy can move here and then we might be able to trap him. These guys are really... Okay, so Gregor is getting scared. Okay, so... And that guy is stunned. Why? Oh, he's on the tracks. Maybe something ran over him. I don't know.
Take this, front face.
Oh, I thought you cursed. Interesting. Also... This is not going too well, is it? Can you hit... Yes, you can actually hit... Okay. I think we might have to just... Yeah, I think we will just have to run. I don't have enough traps. I only have one of these ghoster traps. And that's not going to be enough for all of these dudes. These can only hold 2 ghosts at maximum, so we will have to run and see if we can actually get some money by doing easier missions, and then let's consider getting a new one. Okay, so let's pick that trap up. Well, I can't do that if you are standing there. Can you just, you know, go? Yes, you did. Maybe we could capture this one. And these guys are also leveling up, so... you probably saw that that guy got aim plus one, so... maybe he's a bit better at shooting these ghosts now. And from down here you can also see that we have... cards for this game, so if you want to collect those, you can. Okay. So, it's almost down. Okay, excellent. So, now we... that's basically it, because our other guy doesn't have his trap anymore, so... let's just go to the exit and... no, you were not supposed to shoot there, you were supposed to walk. I'm not happy with you, at all. Okay. Let's just run for it and... try to do some a bit easier missions, because this one was obviously too much for us. At least too much for our equipment. If we had another one of those ghosters, then I would probably be able to... yeah, let's go on. Wait. I thought we were supposed to, you know, go? Equip your team. No, I'm actually going to flee. And you're going to flee also, because you don't have any equipment. And also you leveled up a bit. Okay. So... yeah, better luck next time and we should heal our guys. Yes, yes, I know. And we didn't get any cash from this. Actually, we lost cash because there was collateral damage. But what we can probably do is we can head to HQ and dump some of that ectoplasm away, and then maybe we can go buy some equipment here. If we can, I'm not sure. I spent a lot of money to get this HQ, and that was probably not the best idea to do. At least I have some equipment now. I mean money. So... you had a ghoster, but you don't have that anymore. Oh. Why do you have that? This guy was supposed to have the ghoster. Well, that explains everything. Now I feel like an idiot. So why did you have the ghoster? This dude has to have his own ghoster. Oh, damn it. Okay, let's try that again. Let's actually check the prices at the shop, and we need more fuel soon. This is the fuel meter, basically, so you have to... yeah, this is going to cost too much for us. But yeah, there's a lot of stuff here. We don't even have... well, we do have money for a modified vacuum cleaner. And that one is basically better than the Reliabilator, or whatever this thing is called. Maybe we should sell it. I don't get why this costs more. Does it even do... it doesn't even do more damage than the modified vacuum cleaner. Yeah, I don't think this has any better stats than the modified vacuum cleaner. That's very interesting. Okay, fine, let's get some more fuel and let's see if we can do one more quest and or mission. And okay, so the mission is over. You're almost out of fuel. Yes, I am heading to the gas station now. Okay, so we have a mission. I can probably do both of this stuff, so we can first get some fuel and then we can do this. So my dishwasher started burning. Interesting. Okay. Once I have the fuel, I can head down there. And hopefully none of these other guys actually take our missions. So basically, I'm going to repeat a lot of stuff for those of you who watched the previous video. You might still want to check it out. I'm going to leave the links somewhere next to the video, probably in the article and on the video in the description or something. But yeah, so you're basically competing against these other guys. Okay, so I have all the equipment that I need, and you should probably carry that in your hand and not on your head. Just a tip. I'm not sure if it's midnight, but I don't really care either. Okay, so you should go first because you are the guy with more sanity, so you can actually take a bit more beating. So first of all, we should check where these ghosts are. Nothing here. I'm guessing something might be in these rooms. But yeah, let's get our dudes on the in the hallway and let's. Okay, so we can actually see there, and there's nothing there. Okay. I'm guessing something might pop out from here, so I think we should probably secure the perimeter and then enter. Okay, so there is a Halloween spirit coming down this way, so let's plop that trap down and let's take care of this guy. Okay, can you hit him? Yes. You missed. Okay, so at least the Halloween spirit is dead soon. Or more dead than it. Okay, so some collateral damage. That's... Okay, it's failed. Interesting. And... Okay, so now... the Halloween spirit has zero energy, but the trap has failed twice. Hopefully it works now. Yes, it did. Luckily. Okay, and you should probably check what's going on in that room. Oh, it's a Halloween spirit. Interesting. Okay, so... let's focus on that Halloween spirit then. Okay, so... that Halloween spirit is going to be... trapped in a sec. Yeah, they are having a party there. Seriously, you are so bad at aiming. Okay, so now that's done. There was a ghost somewhere around here, I'm not sure where. But yeah, maybe we should pick that up and move in. The other option is basically staying here, waiting for the ghosts, and then basically using these traps here. I think we should just move in. We can always plop them down if we have to. Okay, so something is going on here. Oh, it's another Halloween spirit. So, I think this guy is a bit more... it's a bit tougher, so let's move here. And let's try to kill it now. It's weird to say that we're going to kill these guys because they're ghosts, but oh well, what if you have another verb for that, then sure, I'll take some tips. Okay, so that Halloween spirit is almost trapped. I left the ghoster there, didn't I? That was probably not the smartest idea. Okay. Okay, so our first ghoster is full, and this other dude is weakened. Okay, so something is really going on in there, and Gregor is freaking out. So I should probably take this ghoster here and move here. Hopefully Gregor doesn't... Okay, Gregor is back, so now I can be a bit more tactical with these two dudes. So you stay there and let's move in through here. Okay, so let's turn the lights on. Another Halloween spirit, but this guy is persistent. So that means he's a bit more tough than his friends were. But I think we're okay, so you should probably also head this way. I'm sure Percy will be able to take care of this dude, but it's better to have more firepower. Okay, so that guy is actually... Oh, he... Yes. So he turned the lights off. Well, you are one annoying ghost. And it's very unlikely that we would be able to hit him. But we can always turn the lights back on. And try to avoid missing. It's going to be messy otherwise. It's already pretty messy though. And you cover your friend's back. That's probably the best way to do this. I hope there are no ghosts in these rooms. Okay, so the ghost is heading this way and he's standing right on top of the ghoster. Oh! I didn't mean to do that! Oh well, we're probably going to get some... money... basically, these guys are probably going to demand some money from us because we are destroying their property so much. Okay, so two more hits and that should be it. Okay, it failed. Hopefully it works now. No, the... This dude is really persistent. Okay, so that was it. And we got a lot of money from this. Excellent. But yeah, let's head back to the HQ and empty those traps. And that should be it. And I think that's probably going to be it for this video as well. So, overall, now that I can save and this game works a bit better in general, it's a good game. It's especially now that I have played some XCOM, so that I can understand this sort of gameplay a bit more. It's a fun game. The graphic style good. The sounds are also very well done. In general, it's a good game. And if you feel that you should have more of these XCOM style games, then absolutely pick it up. It's on Steam, and they are probably still selling the game through their own website, so you can check that out as well. That copy should be DRM free. But yeah, it's a good game. It's a seriously good game. Let's save this game, and I think I might continue this at a later date, maybe in one of our live streams, possibly. I'm not sure, but it's a good game. The developers have fixed all the major issues that I had, and it works. It works pretty well now. But yeah, absolutely go check out the previous video I did on this game. In that game, I basically I explained my first impressions a bit more, though I also complained about the lack of saving back then, so you can ignore that because the saving works now. But yeah, that's basically it. So let's head to the menu and I can quit from here. So this has been me playing Ghost Control Inc. and we will see in the next video.